Praise be to the Lord Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith, the soon coming King. My name is Witness KenPaul Obieke. I'm bringing you Heaven's Mandate's Revival Before Rapture. If you are not ready for rapture, then you are ready for capture. And in order not to be ready for capture, you must be ready for rapture. Jesus is coming very soon, whether anybody believes it or not. It's not the Son of Man that he will lie. I want you to quickly join me as we look at this very topic titled Another Bondage. This is in the series of Errors of the End Time, which I started few weeks ago. And we've been dealing on testing all spirits. Testing all spirits. We have been dealing on that. And today I'm looking into another side of the errors of the end time in respect of the title, Another Bondage. Another Bondage. I'm looking at Colossians chapter number 2. Colossians chapter number 2, verse 21. The word of the Lord says, touch not, taste not, handle not. Now, this is a whole verse of the Bible. And this completely contradicts the liberty that Christ brought for us. When we understand what Christ did on the cross of Calvary, it will help us to know that we, not being under the law anymore, but under grace, are not meant to be put in another bondage of touch not, taste not, handle not. Now, this very scripture is portraying from the angle of the things that of what I'm looking at in this message is portraying the spirit of religion. Now, when we look at the book of Galatians chapter 5, we are starting from verse 1. It says, stand fast therefore in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Take note of again with the yoke of bondage. It says, stand fast therefore in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again, take note of the word again, with the yoke of bondage. Now, yoke of bondage is a terrible thing, and especially when it has to do with religion. And the word of the Lord used that word again for us to understand that there can be different aspect of bondage. The first bondage, when where we were delivered, where we were saved by Jesus Christ, the Lord made me to understand, is nothing compared to the second bondage of religion, because the second bondage of religion is controlled by demons of religion. And under that, you will think you know what you are doing. You will think you are more holy than everybody. You would think that you understand everything more than everybody. You wouldn't want to listen to anybody. You would think you are on the right way to heaven, but you are on the way to hellfire. That is why the second bondage is a terrible bondage. Now, the word of the Lord says in verse 2 of this Galatians chapter 5, behold, I Paul say unto you that if ye be circumcised, Christ shall profit you nothing. Verse 3, for I testify again to every man that is circumcised that he is a debtor to the whole law. Is there any of us that can fulfill the whole law of God. It's not possible. Fulfilling every law is not possible. And if it was possible, Christ would have not come. It is because the law failed that grace came. Nobody can fulfill the whole law of God or the whole laws of God as is being stipulated in the Old Testament, in the Bible. That was why grace came, to help us out. Now, this is not meant to make you an outlaw. And that is where some of us miss it and miss it out. They think that because we are under grace, now it's a license for nonsense. They think that because we are under grace, now you can go about and do things the way you like. It is not what it means at all. We are still in the law. We are not under it, but we are in it. Because the law is our schoolmaster that is meant to teach us. Because without the law, most of us will become lawless. Now, verse 3 says, "For I testify again to every man that is circumcised that he is a debtor to the whole law." That means if you want to observe the law, you must make sure you observe all. And which I'm trying to point out here, that it is not possible. That's why grace came. But grace is not license for nonsense. And some of us are preaching and practicing, and that will end them in hellfire. Now, the word of the Lord said in verse 4, "Christ is become of no effect unto you. Whosoever of you are justified by the law, ye are falling from grace." Can you imagine that? Now, second bondage is falling from grace. And when you fall from grace, you enter into disgrace. A fall from grace lands you into disgrace in hellfire. Because we are saved by grace through faith. And we cannot abandon the grace we are saved by. If you leave what saved you, you cannot remain safe. You must hold on to what saved you if you will remain safe. Now, the Bible says, "For we through the Spirit wait for the hope of righteousness by faith." Hope of righteousness by faith. Not hope of righteousness by "do not touch this, do not handle this, do not taste this," as I have read in the earlier scripture. Now, the word of the Lord says, "For in Jesus Christ neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but faith which worketh by love." If you look around, you will see that the second bondage of religion is putting those of us who think they are practicing holiness into another bondage. Many of them don't have love. Their concentration, their focus is not love. Their focus is just on your outward look. So if you're a witch, you remove those things they don't want to see, then you become holy. And that is wrong. We have seen it proven. I was in one of the holier than thou churches not long ago. A woman that has been in that church for years, who was the head of the choir, was a witch. You know, initiated almost half of the church into witchcraft. She was looking so religious. She was looking so wonderful. If she had love in her heart, she would have not been a witch. And she would have not initiated people into witchcraft. I will still talk to you, but I want us to look at the scripture so that we can get as many as are ready to be set free, to enjoy the liberty of Jesus Christ without abuse. Because some of us abuse grace. Some of us undermine grace. We are meant to use grace, because without grace, we are nowhere. Now, the word of the Lord said, "Ye did run well." Take note of this. "Ye did run well. Who did hinder you that you should not obey the truth?" There are many people that are going to be hindered in their heavenly race. They are going to run ignorantly. They will run outside the truth. And the truth is that without grace, nobody can win the race. Now, this word is stop just going to church. Christianity is not churchianity. Most of us are made churchgoers that are not Christians. This book is going to bless you mightily. This one is the judgment day. The Lord showed me the judgment queue and how the great, the small were judged. You need to know about this so that you can stand on that day. This one is called Tears in Heaven. The book of life was shown to me empty, and Jesus Christ began to shed tears of blood and covered the book of life. It's a book when you read, if you are still of the Lord, your heart will be broken with what is happening. Now, this one is called satanic churches. Most of the churches you have today are satanic because the counterfeit Jesus is what they are worshipping, even in ignorance. Satanic churches is a book that is a spiritual time bomb. When you read it, you understand what I'm saying. Without grace, nobody can win the race. Without grace, nobody, no human being can win the heavenly race. And so the Bible went on and says, this persuasion cometh not of him that calleth you. The persuasion of don't handle this, don't touch this, don't taste this, is coming from the demon of religion that is in charge or behind the second bondage, which many of us are into now, thinking that they are practicing holiness. The other set of people who don't want to hear anything about holiness, who don't want to hear anything about righteousness, who feel that Christ has died for them to go ahead and be doing whatever they like, are doomed in hell. If they do not come to the truth, they can never be set free. But the other people on the other side, who are in second bondage of religion, who are undermining grace, I pity them a lot, because after running, they will run in vain. Because it is grace that wins the race. But this grace is never meant to be abused. It is meant to be used. Because it's even grace that enables you to be able to strive to enter heaven. You can't enter heaven without striving. And Jesus said so. He says, strive to enter. For many will seek to enter, but shall not be able. Which shows that without grace, you cannot be able to even strive to enter heaven. Now, the word of the Lord went on and says, I have confidence. Sorry, let me take verse 9. A little leaven leaveneth the whole lump. Verse 10, I have confidence in you through the Lord, that you will be none otherwise minded. You will be none otherwise minded. But he that troubleth you shall bear his judgment, whosoever he be. Those who put people into second bondage, whether you do it ignorantly, whether you do it out of the dogma or the doctrine of your denomination, is not what the Lord is asking you. Because ignorance is not an excuse. If you use the bondage of religion to send people to hellfire, you will join them there. Making people to think that don't handle this, don't touch this, don't taste this, is the way that making heaven is supposed to be, is putting people in another bondage. Now, the Bible says, and I have confidence in you through that you will be not otherwise minded. Is warning you not to mind this second bondage of religion. But he that troubleth you shall bear his judgment, whosoever he be. And I, brethren, if I preach circumcision, why do I yet suffer persecution? Then is the offense of the cross ceased. I would they were even cut off, which trouble you. For brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Take note of that. We are called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. We are called to liberty. Christianity is a call to liberty. It's not a call to second bondage. Christianity is not a religion. Christianity is not about works. It's about grace. But it is not saying that you don't have good works. A tree is known by its fruits. So the works is the product of your fruit. The product of your fruit is the work. But that is not the real thing. The real thing is that the grace of God that is working in you is what takes all the glory of whatever you are. Take for instance, you are a liar, you don't lie anymore. It's not a work that you are going to boast about. It is the work of grace. And if there is any that will boast, is the grace of God. Paul said it clearly that he is who he is or who he was by the grace of God. That it is the grace that made him to labor more than other people. You know who Paul was? A Saul that grace transformed to a Paul. Now, if you look at the next verse, the Bible says, for all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Now, you will take note that most of us that are more of placing Christianity on work and not grace do not see the relevance of love. Do not understand what love really means. And so many of them are not practicing it. Many of these people, you look at them most of the time, they are moody. The joy of the Lord is not there. They are not enjoying the liberty of Jesus Christ because they are always looking for what to put on the people, to add to people's burdens. That is not Christianity. That is not Christianity. Such burdens will not allow the people to run the race and win. Now, I want you to understand something. One day, I was visiting heaven in divine revelation, heaven and hell in divine relation with Jesus Christ. And what the Lord made me to understand in that very revelation is that all the people putting others in religious bondage, which will not allow them to make heaven, are going to end in hell. In that divine revelation of hellfire, I noticed that the Lord was so angry with these people. Many people that we met in hell were complaining to me that they ran, but they didn't know they were not running well. They were misdirected, they were misinformed, they did not depend on grace to be able to win the race. So they ended up in hell. It was, you know, to them it was, is it possible? Some of them were shouting, I can't believe it. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Now, there was a scenario in Bible where two people went to pray in the house of God. One was acknowledging that he was a sinner and was asking God for mercy. He was attracting grace. And at the end of the day, he ended up vindicated. He ended up better than the one that came in the spirit of religion, that had works but did not get anywhere. The thieves that were crucified with Jesus Christ, one never had work all his life, but righteousness was imputed on him. Grace smiled upon him because he accepted what Jesus Christ stood for. Now, the essence of this message is to help those of us who are building their salvation on works and not grace. And like I tried to mention, that does not mean that as a believer, you are going to go and begin to live in sin and say, because it's not works, that grace will cover you. You will end in disgrace. That is not the point I'm making. But those of us who allow themselves to be put in second bondage of don't touch this, don't handle this, don't smell this, don't use perfume, don't rub cream, don't eat fish, don't smile, don't everything is don't. Christianity has nothing to do with this. Praise God. I want to bring you these heavenly materials. The Lord wants to use them to bless you and to help you at this end time. This one is called Strive to Enter. It's a book you will not afford to miss. The revelations there that will enable you to make heaven. This one is called Behold, I Come Quickly. Everyone that has read this book has a lot to say. And the one thing about my books, they are not just letters. Divine revelations. He said, Behold, I come quickly. Now, this one is Time is Finished. I saw the angels that are meant to blow the trumpet of rapture with trumpets written, time is finished. And the Lord shook the head and told me, the time is finished. Go now and do something. This book will save you a lot. This one is you and your pastor must hear this. It is a book that those who have read got born again and again, even including pastors that really want to make heaven. You and your pastor must hear this. This book is one of my latest books, just out, The Highest Height of the Seed. In this Highest Height of the Seed, you will see how the devil and his cohorts have taken over everywhere in the seed, even preaching holiness and righteousness, even doing what? Bringing so-called divine revelations and so-called undiscerning Christians who are too lazy to test the spirits, are buying their CDs and initiating themselves to hellfire. They do not know that when you watch these CDs, when you look at these things, listen to them, that they grab your soul. Corruption and pollution of another level is what the devil is using now to harvest souls for hellfire. And like I said, most of the time when you look at these people, the joy of the Lord is not there. They are never happy. These are the next Sadducees we have today. And what concerns me a lot is that some of them will, in their sincerity, in which they practice wrong thing that they think is Christianity, are not going to make it at the end. When I was in Divine Revelation of Heaven with Jesus Christ, and the Lord gave me the grace to shake hands with the heavenly witnesses. While we were going through that, I saw a lady called Stella, whose crown was filled with stars. She was a cripple, but you know, she labored so much in trying to win souls, even in that condition. And by the grace of God, she made heaven, and her crown was full of stars for being a soul winner. And the Lord made me to understand why her crown was even bigger than the crowns of some of the apostles. That it was grace. There is nothing grace does not do in the life of somebody. There is grace. The Lord made me to understand that many of the Christians today who are not making it in life is because they don't know how to stay up the grace of God. Even those who are living in sin, struggling with sin, as if sin cannot be overcome, is because you are not stirring the grace of God for that. There is grace of God for everything. And once that grace is stirred up, you can make it in any area and even in eternity. I'm just introducing this message, another bondage, to set free those of us who do not understand that grace is the only thing that will enable you to stand on the day of judgment, and that grace is what wins the race. By next week, when we come back, I'm going to go into more details and with divine revelations that will bless you so wonderfully. See you next week. God bless you. This one is called Meet Jesus Live. Most of us don't know that they can meet Jesus Christ one-on-one. And I have had that experience and still having it all the time. And people who have been under my ministrations have met Jesus Christ physically and spiritually. And he solved their problems, gave them things that nobody can give to them. And the book will help you to know Christ more as a living person that you can interact with. And then stop being fooled by false prophets. Ask anybody that has read this book. It is doing wonders in people's lives. This one is 99% of ministers and churches on the way to hellfire. There was an SOS meeting, and the Lord Jesus Christ came out to drive away many ministers, big ministers that are being respected, and send them to condemnation because we are being held accountable for what is happening in the church. It's a book you will read, you must read. Now, this one is called the battle of sexual immorality. You don't need anybody to tell you that there's a battle going on, even in the church. Even the pulpit has lost the battle. Our schools are high prostitutions, not high institutions. The churches, the choir, everywhere is polluted with sexual immorality. You will find out why. And then find out how to escape. There's a poison called Isana that is in the body of most people you see who are fornicators now. This book will open your eyes like you have never known before. This is pure prosperity. There's no child of God that is meant to be poor. But pure prosperity is not about material things only. This book will teach you on how to prosper spiritually, physically, and otherwise. It will teach you how you can get everything that the Lord has for you in the area of prosperity that is meant to be total, not just one-sided. It's a must read. This one is called Prepare for Rapture. If you are not preparing for rapture, then you are preparing for capture. It is a book that those who have read have repented and got born again and again. Because if you are not ready, you are not going to make it. This book with the revelations and everything inside it will bless you so much. This book is one of my latest books just out. The Highest Height of the Seed. In this Highest Height of the Seed, you will see how the devil and his cohorts have taken over everywhere in the seed. Even preaching holiness and righteousness. Even doing what? Bringing so-called divine revelations and so-called undiscerning Christians. Christians who are too lazy to test the spirits are buying their CDs and initiating themselves to hellfire. They do not know that when you watch these CDs, when you look at these things, listening to them, that they grab your soul. Corruption and pollution of another level is what the devil is using now to harvest souls for hellfire.